Professor Melissa Leach is Vice Chair of Future Earth Science Committee. But what is Future Earth? Why do we need it now? And how will it link to international policy?
Future Earth is a new 10-year research initiative and global platform for research collaboration that was launched last year at the Rio Plus 20 conference. It's aiming to provide a whole new way of doing science for sustainability in a world where we're seeing both incredibly rapid environmental change, but also shifting patterns of deprivation and of inequality. What we urgently need is to build pathways to sustainability that can build well-being and justice for all, including people who are currently very marginalised and poor, without placing undue pressure on the Earth's resources. And this needs new kinds of collaboration between social and natural scientists and new ways of engaging research with the challenges of society itself. Interdisciplinarity across social and natural sciences is something of a holy grail. People talk about it a lot, and it's really hard to make it happen. We need it badly in Future Earth because the problems that we're dealing with are really entangled. They involve social and ecological and environmental and political processes, so we absolutely need them. Some of the barriers in the past have been that there are very different traditions of work, very different ways of evaluating and legitimizing different kinds of data and modeling and analysis in the natural and social sciences, as well as institutional barriers, people working in different kinds of institutions to different funders with different incentives and career structures and so on. To overcome some of these barriers, key ingredients, in my view, are firstly to have some genuinely problem-focused challenges that require the combined forces of social and natural sciences. And Future Earth absolutely offers those, and each of the three themes around dynamic planet, around global development, and around transformation are going to need people to work together. Secondly, it's a lot about relationships. People from different disciplines need to have the time and the trust and the mutual respect to be able to work together, to be able to overcome differences of language, to realize that they are talking about the same thing when sometimes they think they're not, and vice versa. And then finally, I think we need to recognize that day-to-day activities and actually getting out into the field together or sitting together in front of a computer or doing engagement together is often the best way to build those relationships and generate the kind of insights and sort of aha moments that make interdisciplinary work both really exciting and really rewarding. The Future Earth programme was launched at Rio Plus 20 at the same time as the global process to develop a set of sustainable development goals, together with the post-2015 agenda for successors to the Millennium Development Goals. And the aims are very, very similar. It's about a set of global responsibilities to link environment and development, sustainable development. Future Earth, I think, must stay very engaged with the SDG process, helping in its design and eventually in the translation of goals into targets and implementation plans in particular places. And there are two ways it can do that. One is quite obviously to provide scientific ideas, inputs, evidence to design and implementation of the SDGs. But the other is through the engagement capacity and ideas of Future Earth to make sure that the SDG process stays open to recognizing diverse pathways to sustainability, needs and justice concerns in different places around the world, so that ultimately we end up with a political SDG process that is open to debate and open to the diversity of perspectives which can genuinely build justice for all.